गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस मोबिलिटी ऑफ मैकेनिज्म्स और डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम. सो इट इज़ डिफाइंड एज द नंबर ऑफ डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम ऑफ ए लिंकेज इन टर्म्स ऑफ नंबर ऑफ लिंक्स एंड नंबर ऑफ पेयर कनेक्शंस. सो वी एक्सप्रेस मोबिलिटी ऑफ मैकेनिज्म और डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम इन टर्म्स ऑफ नंबर ऑफ लिंक्स एंड नंबर ऑफ पेयर कनेक्शंस. सो कंसिडर एनी लिंक और अ मैकेनिज्म. If the mechanism is a two-dimensional mechanism, if it is a two-dimensional or planar mechanism, then we will consider Grubbler's criteria for it. So here, this criteria is used for finding number of degrees of freedom of two-dimensional mechanism. So if the mechanism is only two-dimensional or planar mechanism, then we will use Grubbler's criteria. It is given by F is equal to 3 into n minus 1 minus 2j minus h, where F is equal to mobility or number of degrees of freedom. N is the number of links including frame, and j is the number of pairs with single degrees of freedom, and h is the number of pairs with 2 degrees of freedom. So if any mechanism is given, we can easily find the degrees of freedom of that mechanism. So n will be the number of links that mechanism have, and j is the number of pairs with single degrees of freedom, and h is the number of pairs with 2 degrees of freedom. So this is how we need to find the degrees of freedom of a mechanism. So if the value of f is greater than 0, then it results in some f degrees of freedom. If f is greater than 0, say for example if it is 1 or if it is 2, then the mechanism is said to be having so many number of degrees of freedom. If we get 1, then it is said to be having 1 degrees of freedom. If it is 2, if we are getting the value as 2, then it is said to be having 2 degrees of freedom, like that. If the value of f is equal to 0, then the mechanism, it becomes a structure. It results in statically determinate structure, because no links are moving in a mechanism. So as per the theory which we have studied earlier, if none of the links are moving, then the mechanism is said to be structure. Next, if the value of f, number of degrees of freedom, is less than 0, then the structure, it results in indeterminate structure or superstructure. That is, it is more stronger than the structure, and sometimes we refer it as indeterminate structure. So indeterminate is, we cannot determine anything about the structure. That is what the meaning is. Now we shall find out some degrees of freedom for simple numerical examples. We shall consider some simple links, and we shall find the number of degrees of freedom. First one, determine the mobility or degrees of freedom of the link shown in figure. So in figure I have taken one simple mechanism. In that mechanism there are 4 links. All the 4 links are given by number 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 4 links, and all the 4 links are numbered with numbers. Now we will consider the Grubbler's criteria, because this is a planar mechanism. So we shall take Grubbler's criteria. F is equal to 3 into n minus 1 minus 2j minus h. So now, as we know, n is the number of links present in the mechanism. So in this mechanism, there are 4 links. So we have to consider the frame also. Here the link 1, it is hatched. It is hatched because that link 1 is fixed on to the ground. So that is what its meaning is. Now we have to consider all the links present in a mechanism. So n is number of links, we shall take it as 4. And j is number of links having single degrees of freedom. So here the value of j will be 4, because link 1 and 2 are fixed, and that fixed point have 1 degree of freedom. And link 2 and 3 are also fixed, and that fixed point have 1 degree of freedom. Link 3 and 4 are also fixed, and that fixed point have 1 degrees of freedom. And link 4 and 1 are also fixed, and that fixed point have 1 degrees of freedom. So adding all the number of degrees of freedom points, we'll get j is equal to 4. And h here, no pair of links have 2 degrees of freedom because all the links are fixed, and hence we shall consider h as 0. Now we shall substitute n and j in the Grubler's criteria formula. So if we find out, we will get the value of f as 1. So f is equal to 1 means there is mechanism is under motion. It has 1 degrees of freedom. It can move in one direction. That is what its meaning is. So we have to write the conclusion as, hence the mechanism has constrained motion, that is 1 degrees of freedom. It has 1 degrees of freedom. So we shall see another problem. So in this problem, we have taken 3 links. All the 3 links are fixed to each other, and link 1 is fixed to the ground. So link 2, 3 are connected. Now again we shall solve the problem. So here in this problem, the number of links is 3. All the links have been named by numbers 1, 2, 3. So n is equal to 3. And j is number of pairs having 1 degree of freedom. Here link 1 and 2 is fixed, and that point have 1 degree of freedom. And link 2 and 3 are also fixed, and that fixed point have 1 degree of freedom. And link 3 and 1 are also fixed, and that fixed point have 1 degree of freedom. So the number of pairs having 1 degree of freedom is 3. So j becomes 3 in this problem. And h, again the value of h is 0 because no pairs have more than 1 degree of freedom. No pairs have 2 degree of freedom or etc. That is why the value of h becomes 0. Now again we shall substitute the value of n and j in the formula, and we shall find the number of degrees of freedom. So number of degrees of freedom we will get as 0 in this problem. So in this problem, no links are under movement or motion. No links will move. Hence, this is a statically determinate structure. If the value of f is 0, then we will get the structure, the mechanism as structure, because no links are moving here. All the links are fixed. We'll see another problem. So here, here also there are 4 links. And we have numbered the links with numbers. Here the fixed part we shall consider as single one link. So the link 4 here is fixed, so we shall consider it as a link, single link. Again we shall take the same formula, Grubler's criteria. So n here, a number of links are 4 because we have link 1, link 2, link 3 is piston here, and link 4 is the fixed hinge. Here link 3 is a reciprocating piston, and hence there are 4 links. We shall consider n as 4. Next we shall consider j. So number of pairs having same 1 degree of freedom. So here there are 4 pairs with a single degree of freedom because fixed hinge 1 and 1 have 1 degree of freedom. Link 1 and 2 have 1 degree of freedom. Link 2 and 3 have 1 fixed point have them, and they have 1 degree of freedom. And their link 3 and 4 also have 1 degree of freedom mechanism. Hence the value of j becomes 4 in this problem. The value of h, again here there is no values of h because no links have more than 1 degree of freedom. So now substituting all the values in the above formula f, we will get the value of f as 1. So here also the mechanism has constrained motion, hence it has 1 degree of freedom. The mechanism given has 1 degree of freedom. So this is how we need to calculate the degrees of freedom of any given mechanism. So in next class we shall solve some more problems, so that we will get some idea based on the calculation of number of degrees of freedom. Thank you guys.